Om Shanti. Today is 15 August and this is a very important day for our country because on this day, on 1947, we are free from all the bondages and all the other countries' peoples. So, happy Independence Day to all of you and enjoy the day and make yourself free from all the negative feelings and all the low-stream concepts and thoughts. Now, we are listening golden versions of Bab Dada. Essence is, sweet children, whatever happens at every step is beneficial. In this drama, those who stay in remembrance of the father experience the most benefit. Question is, by knowing which secret that is fixed in the drama, can children maintain infinite happiness? Answer is, those who know that according to the drama, this old world is now going to be destroyed, can maintain infinite happiness. There will also be natural calamities, but your kingdom is definitely going to be established and no one can do anything to prevent it. The state of you children fluctuates. Sometimes you have a great deal of enthusiasm and sometimes you become cool. However, you must not become confused about that. Maintain the happiness that God, the Father of all souls, is teaching you. Song, the flame has ignited in the happy gathering of moths. Om Shanti. Baba is giving love and remembrance to all sweetest living moths who are number wise. According to your efforts, all of you are living moths. The father is called the flame, but no one knows him at all. The flame is not large. He is just a point. It doesn't enter the intellect of anyone that a soul is a point and that a whole part is recorded in each soul. The knowledge of souls and the Supreme Soul is not in the intellect of anyone else. The Father has come and explained to you children. He has given you realization of the soul. Previously, you neither knew that a soul is nor what the Supreme Soul is. Therefore, because of their body consciousness, children have a load of attachment and also many vices. Bharat was so elevated. There was no mention of vice at all. That was the viceless Bharat. It is now virtuous Bharat. No human being can explain this to you in the way that the Father explains. I made this land into Shivalaya 5,000 years ago. I myself established Shivalaya. How? Baba says, how we are established Shivalaya. Now explaining that, you now understand this. You know that whatever happens at every step is beneficial. Every day become more and more beneficial for those who remember the Father very well and benefit themselves. This is the benevolent age in which you become the most elevated beings. There is so much praise of the Father. You know that the true Bhagavat is now being enacted. When the path of devotion begins in the copper age, you are the first ones to create an oval image of diamonds and worship that. You now remember that you built temples when you were worshippers. You used to build them of diamonds and emerald. You can't obtain those images now. People here make the same images of them in silver in order to worship them. Look how much regard there is for such worshippers. Although everyone worships Shiva, that is still not unadulterated worship. You children also know that destruction is definitely going to take place. Preparations for that are now taking place. Natural calamities are also fixed in the drama. No matter how much someone beats his head over it, your kingdom is definitely going to be established. No one has the power to do anything about this. However, the state of your souls does fluctuate. This is a huge income. Sometimes you have very good thoughts because you are happy, whereas at other times you become very cool. Even on a pilgrimage, there is fluctuation. It is the same here. Sometimes when you wake up in the morning, there is a great happiness in remembering the Father. Oh, Baba is teaching us. It is such a wonder. God, the Father of all souls, is teaching us. They believe that Krishna is God. Throughout the whole world, there is a lot of regard for the Gita because it says in it, God speaks. However, no one knows who God is. No matter how great the positions that scholars and pandits have, and even though they say that they remember God, the Father, they have forgotten when He comes and what He does when He comes. The Father continues to explain all of these things to you. All of this is fixed in the drama. This kingdom of Ravan will exist once again, and we will have to enter it once again. It is Ravan who puts you to sleep in the extreme darkness of ignorance. Only the ocean of knowledge gives you knowledge through which there is salvation. No one except the Father can grant you salvation. The bestower of salvation for all is just the One. The knowledge of the Gita that the Father gave to you has disappeared. It is not that this knowledge continues free from time immemorial. The Quran and the Bible, etc., continue. They are not destroyed. The Quran and the Bible, etc., continue. They are not destroyed. The scripture is not created from the knowledge that I give you now. That is would become eternal and continue all the time. You write this down and then have it destroyed. All of this will be burnt and finished naturally. The Father told you this a cycle ago and is also telling you now. You receive this knowledge now and you will then receive the reward. Therefore, there is no need for the knowledge here. Where? In the golden age. We are not need any knowledge in the golden age. On the path of devotion, there are all the scriptures. Baba doesn't relate this knowledge to you by reading the Gita. He is giving you the teaching of Raj Yoga. They create scriptures from this on the path of devotion and mix everything up. Therefore, the main aspect, see, you have to explain is who give the knowledge of the Gita. This is the main point. Who give the knowledge of the Gita? They have replaced the name of that one. No one else's name has been replaced. All other religions have their main religious scriptures. The main religions are Deism, Islam, and Buddhism. Some say that there was the first Buddhism and then Islamism. Tell them that such things are not connected with the Gita. We are only concerned about claiming our inheritance from the Father. The Father explains so clearly that this is a big tree. It is very good. It is like a flower vase. Three tubes emerge from it. The tree has been created to give such clear understanding. Anyone can very quickly understand which religion he belongs to and who established that religion. Dayanand and Aurobindo Ghosh, etc., have recently been and gone. They too taught yoga, etc., but all of that is devotion. There is no name or dress of knowledge. They have been given such huge titles. All of that is fixed in drama. It will happen again after 5,000 years. You know how the cycle continues to turn from the beginning and how it will repeat again. The present time will become the past and it will then become the future. It is said past, present and future. Whatever is the past then become the future. You receive knowledge at this time and you then claim your kingdom. It used to be the kingdom of deities. At the time, there was no other kingdom. Tell them all of this in the form of a story. It will become a very beautiful story. Long, long ago, 5,000 years ago, Bharat was the golden age. Tell them stories. For 1250 years, it was the kingdom of Lakshmi and Narayan. Then they give their kingdom to their brothers, the warriors, and their kingdom then continued. You can explain that the Father came and taught you. Those who had studied well become part of Sun dynasty. Those who failed were named warriors. However, there was no question of a war, etc. Baba says, children, remember me and you will be absolved of your sins. You have to conquer the vice. The Father has issued their ordinance. Which ordinance? Remember me and you will be solve your sins. Baba says that those who conquer lust become conquerors of the world. Later, after half the cycle, they fall on to the path of sin. There are their images. The features are those of deities. The kingdom of Ram and the kingdom of Ravan are half and half. Create a story about this and explain what happened next and what happened after that. This is the story of the true Narayan. Only the one Father is the truth. He is now giving you the knowledge of the beginning, the middle, and the end. No one else can give you this knowledge. Human beings don't even know the Father. If they don't know the creator or director of the drama in which they are the actor, who else would? If actor knows the director and the main actor and creator of the drama, Who would know? The father is now explaining to you that all of this will happen in the same way according to the drama. The father will come to teach you again. No one else can come here. The father says, I only teach you children. No new people can sit here. There is the story of Indraprastha. There are the names of the different angels like there are some amongst you who are like diamonds. Look how Ramesh created the exhibition through which everyone started to think about that. Therefore, he did something for diamonds. Some are tops and others are of another type of jewels. Some knows nothing at all. You know that a kingdom is being established. Kings and queens, etc., are all needed in that. You know that you Brahmins are studying by following Shrimad and that you will then become the masters of the world. You should have so much happiness. This land of death is now going to be destroyed. Even at this time, this Baba understands that he is to go and become a baby. Brahma Baba understands that. The things of that childhood are coming in front of him now, and so his whole behavior changes. In the same way, when they become old there, they understand that they will shed their old bodies and go into the childhood stage. Childhood is the Satopradhan stage. Lakshmi and Narayan have the stage of adults. When they are married, they are not said to be in their adolescence. The adult stage is said to be the Rajo stage and the elderly stage is said to be the Tamo stage. This is why there is great love for Krishna. Lakshmi and Narayan are the same ones, but people doesn't know these things. Krishna has been shown in the Copper Age and Lakshmi and Narayan in the Golden Age. You are now making effort to become deities. The father says, Kumaris should become very active. There are the temple to the Kumaris and the half Kumaris. All the temples like the Dilwara temple, etc. are your accurate memorials. Those are non-living, whereas this is the living one. We are sitting here in the living form. Madhuban is living Dilwara temple. We are making Bharat into heaven. Heaven will be here. You children, now everything about where the incorporeal world is and where the subtle reason is. You know the whole drama. Baba says, whatever has become the past will then become the future and then the past. This is the cycle. You have to understand who it is that is teaching you. God is teaching us. You should become very cool and calm and be happy. By staying in remembrance of the Father, all your confusion is removed. Baba is our Father. He teaches us and he will then take us back home with him. Consider yourselves to be souls and talk to the Father, the Supreme Soul, in this way. Baba, I now understand. I also understand about Brahma and Vishnu. Brahma emerged from the navel of Vishnu. Vishnu is shown in a lack of milk and Brahma is shown in the subtle reason. In fact, he exists here. Brahma exists in this land. Vishnu is the one who rules. If Brahma emerged from Vishnu, then he too would definitely rule if he emerged from the navel of Vishnu, that would be like becoming a child. The father sits here and explains all of these things. Brahma completes his 84 births and then becomes the master of the land of Vishnu. Some doesn't understand these things very well, and so their mercury of happiness doesn't rise. You are these, Baba says that, you are these gopis and gopis, they don't exist in the golden age. There you will be prince and princess. Gopi Valla is the father of the gopis and gopis. Prajapita Brahma is the father of everyone, whereas the father of all souls is incorporeal Shiva. All of you are the mouths born, Baba says that, all of you are the mouth born creation. All of you, Brahma, Kumar and Kumaris, are brothers and sisters. There must not be any criminal reason. It is in this that Maya defeats you. The father says, remove from your intellect everything you have studied up to now. Study the things that I am telling you. Forget all about which you studied in past. Now only remembering which Baba studied us. So Baba says that the picture of the ladder is first class. Everything depends on one thing. Who is the God of the Gita? Krishna can't be called God. He is a deity full of all virtues. His name is mentioned in the Gita. He is portrayed as dark blue, and Lakshmi and Narayan are also portrayed as dark blue. They can't account for this. They have even portrayed Ramchandra as dark view. The father says he become like that by sitting on the prey of lust. Although the name of one is mentioned, it applies to all. All of you are Brahmins. You are now sitting on the prey of knowledge. Shudra sit on the prey of lust. The father says, turn the ocean of the knowledge and create methods to awaken others. They will, of course, awaken according to the drama. The drama moves very, very slow. Acha, to the sweetest, beloved, long lost, and now found children, love, remembrance, and good morning from the father, the mother, and Bab Dada. The spiritual father says namaste to the spiritual children. The spiritual children says namaste to the spiritual father. Now, essence for dharana. First point is, always remain aware that you are the gopis and gopis who belong to Gopi Valla. By having this awareness, the mercury of your happiness will always remain high. Second point is, remove from your intellect everything you have studied up to now and study the things that the father now telling you. Finish your criminal eye with the awareness of being brothers and sisters. Don't be defeated by Maya. Blessings. Baba bless us with the blessings of, may you show the practical form of royalty with your reality. May you show the practical form of royalty with your reality and become an image that grants reasons. Such a time is now to come when you souls will grant a vision of your royalty through your reality in a practical way. At the time of revelation, the number of the beads of the rosary and also the form of the future kingdom will be revealed. Now, while you raise the curtain of a little dust of competition is hiding the sparkling diamonds. At the end, however, the curtain will be removed and the hidden diamonds will reveal their complete and perfect forms. The royal family will show their royalty from now, that is, they will reveal their future status. So, grant a vision of royalty through your realty. Slogan is, finish all wastefulness with any method. Finish all wastefulness with any method and let the powerful emerge. Okay, Om Shanti. Now we are remembering Baba for the 5 minutes.
जैसे तृप्ति मिली तपते मन को मेरी आत्म तृप्ति मिली बुझ रहे दीप को जैसे तृप्ति मिली जब पड़ी आपकी दृष्टि हम पर प्रभु जब पड़ी आपकी दृष्टि हम पर प्रभु जैसे जीवन मिला ज्योति जगती मिली जैसे जी